Hello friends, in this video series I am going to create a complete project step by step using Spring, Hibernate, AngularJS, and for front end designing I am going to use Bootstrap. Now you might be wondering what I am going to build. Well, I am going to build an online shopping website. Then what is the difference from all the other videos that you are going to find on different channels on YouTube? Well, you see, in most of the videos the information are given in bits and pieces, but here I am going to cover everything, the errors that you get, plus I am going to upload this project on GitHub so that my code can be reviewed with others as well. As a prerequisite, I am going to use various tools, so I have listed down the tools that I am going to use. First of all, since this is a Java based project, so I need to install JDK. So I am using the latest version along with the path setup, and also I have configured the Java home variable inside my environment variables. Now I have also installed Git for our version control, because as I told you, I am going to also show how to upload your project on GitHub. Plus I am using Eclipse. At the time of this recording I am using the version Mars, but there are different versions also available. You can try this thing with others version of Eclipse too. Apache Tomcat, so as my web container, so I'm going to use the version 8, and I need a GitHub account to push the project from my local machine to the cloud repository, that is on GitHub. Okay, so I will start with my part 1 of this series, that is creating a project directory and uploading in GitHub repository. Okay, so I've listed down the step, because as I told you, I'm going to teach you everything step by step, covering up all the errors. So the first step is to create an empty Git repository on GitHub. So I'm going to select a repository name. So I've decided I'm going to keep it as online shopping. So this is my GitHub account. I've already logged in. My GitHub account name is Rusty Amigo. So here I'm going to create a new repository, and I'm going to name it as online shopping. Okay, so this is a repository name that I am going to use. Now there are a few things that you need to do, so that I have written in step 2. Check to add the readme.md file and select your technology to add it inside the gitignore file. Now what is this gitignore file would do? It will exclude all the classes that are generated while your project gets compiled, because anyways, if anyone is having your Java source code, they can compile and get the classes file. So I am going to write those folders inside gitignore. So that's why I need this gitignore file. So here I'm going to initialize my repository with the readme, and plus I need to select the technology on which I'm going to work. So I'm going to work with Java technology, and I'm simply going to create this repository. So as you can see, a readme.md file has been created, which I'm going to update later, and a gitignore file is there. If you click on this gitignore file, you can see star.class, star.jar, var, er file, all those files that is not required, that could be easily compiled and packaged into different packages, is been written inside your gitignore file. Okay, now inside my third step, I am going to copy the GitHub repository URL. Now where you can find this GitHub repository URL? You can see this clone or download button here. This is your GitHub repository URL. You can simply copy to the clipboard. So I have copied this thing. Next. Since I am going to use Eclipse, so I need to open my Eclipse ID, which I have already opened. Okay. It will ask you to use your workspace. You can use any workspace in your directory, in your drive. Now, fifth step, go to Window, Show View, Other, and type git on the filter and select git repositories. So I'm going to go to Window, Show View, Other. I'm going to filter out as git. So you can see there is this git repository available command. I'm going to open it. So it is opening a dialog box. Now why I have opened this dialog box? Because I told you I'm going to work with GitHub. So I need to clone that repository which I've created just before. So I am just going to click on clone at git repository. Since I have copied already inside my clipboard, you can see every information is available here. Now I don't have to give any username password. I am just going to click on next. So So it has got the information from my repository link which I have given. Click on next. Now here is the important step, where you want to store your project. So basically I'm going to store it inside my D directory, where I like to keep all my projects. D project spring. Okay, and I'm going to click on save. So as you can see, D project spring online shopping. So there will be another directory which will be created with the name of online shopping, and click on finish. So as you can see, this online shopping master has been created. If you expand this, you can see the working directory. There is two files available, gitignore and readme. What I will do next is I'm going to create the projects. Why I'm telling it as a project, because I'm going to create two different projects. One will be the front end project and another one will be the back end project. In front end project, I'm going to work with the user interfaces, and in the back end project, I'm going to work with database classes so that I can access data easily, and I'm going to pass it to my front end project. So now clone this repository at your desired location, which I've already did. Now the first step, I'm going to create the Maven web app project. Web app project will be used for creating your user interfaces. So I'm going to go to file, new Maven project. Now it will ask you where you want to store this project. Now this is another important step, because I've already cloned my repository. So I'm going to uncheck it, browse, and I'm going to go inside my D drive, projects, spring project, and there is this online shopping. I'm going to select OK. So D project spring online shopping, next. Now here I need to select the filter, which archetype I want. So I'm going to select the archetype as web app. Click on next. Now here I'm going to give it name as artifact ID. So this is my, say, online shopping. So the package name would be online shopping, net.kzn.onlineshopping, that's fine. And I'm going to click on finish. I'm going to cancel it. As you can see, this project has been created right now. Now need to add it to the repository which I have already cloned. Okay. So how can you add it to the repository? You need to right click on the project, select the team command and share project, and select the git repository which was created above. So I'm going to simply right click on this one. There is this option called as team, share project, and if you uncheck it, you will get this repository, because you can have more than one repository in your git dialog box that you just opened before. So that's why I just unchecked it, just to let you know that I can select the repository in which I want to store. So I'm going to select this, okay, check mark this thing and say finish. As soon as I click this, you can see there is this online shopping master which has been added here. It means now this project is entirely version controlled using git. That's why you can see this command. Now similarly, I'm going to create the Maven quick start project. This quick start project will help me to get the data from the database by creating all the different classes and entities for my project. So I'm going to quickly go to file, new Maven project. Again, where is the location? So the location would be, I'm going to say browse. There are two online shopping available. Reason is because this is my front end project and this is the repository. So I'm going to select this repository part. Okay, you can see the difference. There is this hyphen and there is this online shopping which I created in my web app project. So I'm going to select this online shopping, the git part. I'm going to click on next, and I'm going to select the quick start. Next. net.kz, and I'm going to say this is my shopping backend. So online shopping and shopping backend. Click on finish. Now again, I want to make this project to be part of my online shopping master. By default it is all, because there was only single Git repository available. It has already added into Online Shopping Master. You can simply right click, go to team, and you can see all these things are available. That's fine. If you cannot find all these things, you can go to team and share project. You can use the previous thing that I did for my online shopping project. So it has been already added inside my Online Shopping Master because I choose that online shopping detail. Now there are a few things that I need to do. I'm going to open the gitignore file and ignore the target folder of both the project. You can see here it creates a target folder. So all your Java classes that gets compiled are stored inside this target folder. So I don't want this target folder to get uploaded. So what I will do, I will open this gitignore file. I'm going to add both the project name online shopping / target. Next, I'm going to write shopping backend / target, and I'm going to save it so that this target folder does not get uploaded in my GitHub repository. I don't want that classes to get uploaded, so that's why I've written this target folder. Now, open the window preference and filter for Git configuration. Before uploading anything on GitHub, you need to identify yourself. So for identifying yourself, you need to specify what is the username and email. So for doing that configuration, you need to go to window preferences and you can select Git. You can filter Git. You can see there is this option available, configuration. There are no entries available. If you find any entries like user with name and email, that's fine. So you can simply ignore this step. If you cannot find that information, you can click on this configuration, add an entry with a key as user.name. So value, I'm going to provide my name. So you can see the key is user.name and the value is my name. Okay, so you can see the key has been added here. So that's what it is given in your 11th step. Click on add entry and you can give the key as user.name and your name. Similarly, I'm going to provide the email just to identify myself. So I'm going to add another entry and I'm going to say user.email. I'm going to provide my email ID. Okay. I'm going to say apply and I'm going to say okay. Now right click on the repository and select the commit. So where is that repository? Here it's the repository. I'm going to right click and there is this option available called as commit. Now once this commit option gets open, you can see there is this open Git staging view. So I want to open this staging view because every file that should get committed should be first put inside the staging area. So how can I put that thing inside staging area? So you need to select all the files in the unstaged changes. So you can see here there is unstaged changes available. I'm going to do a control A, select all the files and drag and drop it in state changes. Once this is done, enter your commit message. So you can enter the commit message here, my project setup completed success. Click on the commit and push it. Once you click on that button, it will ask you for your credential. So that place you need to enter your GitHub account username and password. So I'm just going to simply click on commit and push. It will give me a window where I'm going to put my username. So my GitHub username is Rusty Amigo. Password is, no, I'm not going to tell you my password. So it has pushed to this particular repository. As you can see, it has given me this message. Okay, so just to quickly verify it, I'm going to go to my this online shopping which I've already created. I'm going to click on this online shopping. You can see the two projects are uploaded here, online shopping and shopping backend. Okay, now if I click on this online shopping, you can see there is no target folder here because I've already put it inside my gitignore. And if you see the shopping backend, again there is no target folder here. Okay, so click on OK. Okay, done. We can completely close this thing. These two projects are already here. And in my next part, I am going to build the user interface in the web app project. So in that web app project, I am going to do all the latest configuration. So stay tuned till my next video. Thanks for watching.